plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
Welcome to this week's plumberparts.co.uk video. Hold tight, welcome to today's plumberparts.co.uk video. My name's James, and today, this is like the simplest video you could ever think of doing. We've been requested to do it by a lovely one of our viewers, who said, I'm trying to fit a new washing machine, and I need to know how to cut a T into some pipe. So what we're going to do, we're going to show you, there's a few different ways of doing it, but it's all about the measurements. So this video is not going to be very, very long at all. In the meantime, if you missed out on our last video, we're going to leave a little link to that for you to click on to watch right about here. Alright? So anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's video. It's going to be genuinely 1.5 minutes long, and then I'll have a little chit chat with you at the end, a little bit of a debrief, a little bit of chinwag, let you know what I've been up to, all that sort of stuff. Alright? Hold tight! So here we go. Let's just say we've done a little muck up here. We've got some pipe that we've just clipped to the wall, just like so. And we've got a few different types of fitting as well. So we've got a little Hepto push fit fitting, and we've also got a standard NFT as well. For some reason, I couldn't find any equal T's in compression. So just to show you how you actually do your cut, we've just got ourselves a little isolation valve just here. Now, the most important thing about this is just measuring how much pipe you cut out, okay? This job can be quite difficult if you don't have any flex in the pipe. Whereby, what I mean by that is if you cut this, if you just did one cut and you could just pull them apart and then pop your T in and then pop it back together, then that'd be really easy, wouldn't it? You'd be like, oh my god, I've just done it, it was so easy, why did I even have to watch a video? But that pretty much never ever happens. So I mean, most plumbers, right, know, I mean, I know exactly how much to take out. If I'm doing a T, usually the width of your little finger, if you've got a finger that's about a centimeter wide, if you've got chubby fingers, then obviously make account for that. All right maybe half an hour if you're a chubby person. And let's say, right, basically, if you've got some clips here like this, what you're going to need to do, if you want to get your pipe size around, because really you should be using a pipe size for this sort of job. If you've got a hacksaw, then you're not going to have to worry about it so much. But the thing is you're going to have to take off and try and remove the old clips, okay? Easy to pop a clip off. You should just get yourself a little slotted screwdriver, get under there like that. As you can see, that clip's been undone a few times. It's a little bit knackered. And then what you're going to be able to do is just prise this pipe off just like so. And pretty much then get your cutter under here like that, okay? And then you use the arrow on your cutter to know which way to rotate it. Anyway, as you're probably aware, subscribers of old, legends, beasts, gentry of the plumbing world, this is a very, very simple video, but let's just come along and watch it anyway for the ride. I've just knelt in a load of water. Oh my God! God, this is turning into a really realistic video. Basically, what I say is, like, I always go width of the little finger. If you really, really want to do it properly, you can get yourself a pencil, pop the T on the thing, and then basically use the sides of the shoulders of the T and mark a little bit of pencil line there and there. This is if you don't have any flex. If you've got flex, you don't have to worry about it. You can just cut it like this. Just like that. And then once you've cut it, obviously, if you've got enough flex, you've got a small gap here. We should just be able to grab this pipe or one of these pieces of pipe and pull that away. So once they're pulled away enough, and you can slide your fitting in. So let's say we're going to do this solder fitting here. Obviously, we'll put flux on this. But just push that in like so, and then that'll be nice and sorted out, ready for us to pop another bit of pipe on and solder up and get installed. We'll leave you some links at the end of this video for how to solder pipes, how compression fittings work, and also how push fit fittings work. Oh my God. Now, the thing is, right, this is all well and good for if you've got problems with how much flex you've got. So say we don't have enough flex to get this particular small fitting in. What I'd do is, if I had a bit of flex, I'd pull back as far as about here, if I could, to about there. And then if I could pull this pipe out, I can actually push this on this end here, just about get that in and push them back together again. It's all about how much force you want to put on the pipe to be able to split it apart far enough to make sure that you aren't going to bend it or cause problems when it comes to sealing it up in a minute. Another trick to do, especially if you've got compression fitting like this, is obviously this fitting, when it's in that sort of situation, is quite long, okay? So if you don't have enough spring, maybe it's a good idea that you slacken your nut and olive off, actually take them off each one of these, and then put the nut and olive on first, like so, okay? So they're already on the pipe, you've cut it already, and now you're just pushing them onto each side of the pipe like this. But now look how narrow that body is. So you can now slip this body really easily into here, push the fitting up together, and then tighten that up like that. Unfortunately, this kind of trick doesn't work for push fit fittings because they're all part of one kind of thing. They're quite difficult to take apart, and you also need to know what you're doing. If it's a JG speed fit fitting, yes, you will definitely be able to do that, but as I said, you need to know what you're doing. So like I said, this is a very basic video, but it's obviously something that's troubled some of you, and I hope this video has helped you out. As you can see, it's all about how much pipe you cut out, okay? If you cut too much pipe out, you can't just add it on again. It's like putting too much of a certain ingredient in a nice din-dins. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed today's really, really simple video. I hope you subscribe to our videos. You can share them as well. You can follow us on Twitter and Facebook. If you've clicked on the video at the start of this, you'll realise that a lot of the stuff we do is retweeting photos that you've sent us. If you've got any questions, you can ask us there. But even better, if you like our Facebook page, you can send us a video question to our Facebook page. And if it's good enough, we'll include it in our Ask the Plumber video and you'll get a sticker as well. I hope you enjoyed today's video and I'll see you in the next week's one, which is going to be probably a From the Van or maybe an Ask the Plumber. But who cares? It will have lashings of fun and hopefully a bit of that tabby beast known as Big G. Anyway, I'll see you soon, everyone, and hold tight!
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
George? Treats, George. Treats. What's this?